Now, a short introduction from the producer's legal representative, Mr. Abe Appenheim.
And now for something completely different.
From the producers of Salmonella the Musical and Invasion of the Metaphors comes Monty Python, the truth. Well, almost the truth.
I don't think anybody had the slightest interest in each other as people.
Graham was a mystery.
Yes, I did a lot of drinking, a great deal, a very great deal indeed, Michael, yes.
Terry cared about everything. It didn't matter how tiny the detail. He really, really felt.
I kept telling John, John, you're a freak. Relax.
Michael Palin, yes, he's the sort of kind of forgotten man of the group, really.
I think Terry can only operate in opposition. He has to have an enemy.
Eric is the most astute financially.
Good evening and welcome to the money program.
Idel must be Jewish name somewhere down the line, mustn't he, eh? Look at the way he likes the money.
A feature-length film with all the searing drama.
Well, the new Monty Python film has managed to offend just about every religious group in the city.
Graham Chapman, one of the founder members of the Monty Python team, has died.
Good riddance to him, the freeloading b****.
Gut-busting comedy.
I'll tell you what's wrong with it. It's dead.
I'd like to answer this question, if I may, in two ways.
Look, you stupid b****, you've got no arms left.
Firstly, in my normal voice, and then in a kind of silly, high-pitched whine.
Just a flesh wound.
The heinous lies.
It was so bizarre that he made a lot of money selling his story that he had kicked the big C and he was clean. After he got the paycheck, he died.
Those unforgettable songs.
Always look on the bright side of life.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night, I work all day.
And famous people who never met them, talking like they really knew them. Monty Python, Almost the Truth. Coming soon to a big screen near you. Well, big-ish.